The Radio Memories Network is brought to you in part by Liberated Syndication, podcast publishing made easy, libsyn.com. That's libsyn.com.
Welcome to the Old Time Radio Network Western Stories, riding into the Wild West of gunfighters, tales of cattle drives, and sheriffs. Ha, those tales of rough and rowdy adventures of those heroes of the Wild West. We now go back to the early days of Westerns on the radio and our imaginations with our feature presentation.
In 1933, producer George W. Trendle and writer Fran Stryker had the Lone Ranger ride out of the western sky, and it was, "Hi-O Silver, Away," from then on via Mutual nationally until 1954. Always at his side was his faithful Indian companion, Tonto, portrayed by John Todd, who was a loyal, intelligent, and resourceful Indian. Grace Beamer began as announcer, but after the tragic auto death of Earl Grazer in 1941, took the role of the Lone Ranger. He could be tough as nails with the outlaw types, but gentle and understanding with the honest townsfolk. His quest for justice in the West was detailed in hundreds of episodes, and always, it seemed, Tonto and the Lone Ranger rode off before they received the thanks they were due. Though directed toward the kids, the Lone Ranger Half Hours had a wide following, for the stories resonate with that righteous purpose, selfless dedication, and an ongoing struggle against lawlessness and corruption. Now join us for an exciting episode of The Lone Ranger.
The Lone Ranger. Cattle were driven north to the railroad towns from the southern Texas ranches. The Lone Ranger led the fight for law and order in the range country. Rustlers and hostile Indians attacked the honest ranchers constantly, and it was only through the strength and courage of the masked rider of the plains that peace and security were brought to the frontier. Return with us now to those thrilling days when the West was young. From out of the past come the thundering hoofbeats of the great horse Silver. The Lone Ranger rides again.
Come, Silver! The head of the Tomahawk Basin!
On the day Breed Gomez, the Tomahawk foreman, was to be tried, the courtroom in Leadville was crowded. Everyone knew it was the Lone Ranger who had obtained the evidence against him. But so far, Benjamin Steele, who had said nothing for or against his former employee, would he stand by him or condemn him? The question remained unanswered when the judge rapped for order.
Who is this? Case of Jim Carey versus Breed Gomez. Get all the witnesses lined up, Sheriff?
Your Honor, that's it.
Who's that?
Benjamin Steele. I hold this trial as illegal.
What do you mean by that?
This was the charge.
Oh, you ought to know that. Poison in the water hole.
And who brought the charge?
Why, Jim Carey here.
He's got no right to bring charges. The water hole is on my land. If I don't want to bring charges, nobody can.
Now, wait a minute there. He poisoned my water hole, too.
You just figure he did. You got no proof.
Well, he must have.
You got any evidence?
No, we caught him at your water hole, but
and
I said...
it still goes. I'm the only one who can bring charges.
Your Honor... you know how all this happened. Breed was really trying to kill off my cattle. He sent word to me that I could use Steele's waterhole. I got that message after he poisoned.
Now, hold on there. Did Breed give you that message himself?
It was Ted Bailey brought it, but Breed told him to.
You got any proof of that?
I got Ted's word.
Is that enough, Your Honor?
Not unless there was witnesses.
Yeah.
feels right about the legal part of this case, Carey. He's the only one who's got the right to bring charges. But I want to tell him here and now it's his duty to do it.
I get an answer to that.
Well, out with it.
Reed's worked for me for a long time. He's a good foreman. And I need him to run the Tomahawk. I'll admit he made a mistake, but most of us do every now and then. Not even the Lone Ranger would stop an honest man from getting a second chance.
An honest man?
That's what I said. Reed figured you ought to sell your land to me for your own good. You've got sort of options about it. He just figured out this little trick to make a change of mind.
It was crooked.
It was wrong, I'll admit. But I'll answer for him, for to everybody in this courtroom and everybody in the Tomahawk Basin. He won't try anything like it again. That's why I'm not bringing charges against him. Your Honor, I'm calling on you to throw this case out of court.
I object. Well, rightly speaking, there is no case. Objection overruled. Release the prisoner. Court adjourned.
Stop you, senor. You will not be sorry for what you have done today.
I know that, Reed.
Sure you do. And every small rancher here knows it, too. You think you put one over on us, but you haven't.
Reed isn't going to jail, Terry. The Lone Ranger didn't accomplish anything by getting him arrested.
Oh, yes, he did. He's forced you to put your cards on the table. You can't pretend to be friendly to us anymore. You were trying to drive us all out of the basin. And from now on, it's war.
Now on, it's war. Yes, Otto. Terry told the truth.
Tomahawk outfit plenty strong.
Strong as all the other outfits put together. Steele is smart. Instead of breaking the law, he'll use it. He'll use his money to force the small ranchers into bankruptcy. He's got to frame them for rustling and send them to jail.
Him plenty bad.
But he won't attack them openly until everything else has been tried. He must make sure his plan failed, Kimasabi. Afterwards, when he's turned his back on the law, we'll have a chance to put him where he belongs.
And make him pay.
For everything. For every head of cattle. For every ranch he's stolen. And most of all, for something we can't prove.
You mean Black Arrow?
Yes. He'll pay for his treason.
Plan is simple, Breed. The thing I like about it is that it's legal.
Legal?
Yes. The other ranch is coming with around us.
They'll just about start it.
It is?
Yeah, it's the same with the Tomahawk.
We've got to finish first, that's all. You haven't got nearly enough men.
Oh, si, senor, we have plenty.
That's what I'm planning. Let Whitey take charge for a few days, and you head down to San Antonio. Hire every man you can find to get back here by the end of the week with 100 at least.
100?
At least. And as many more as you can find.
He's loco, senor.
How many men would you need to drive a trail herd of 50,000 to market?
Well, we will not have 50,000 here. 5,000, maybe, but 50,000, no.
50,000, yes.
Senor. Well,
what's more, they have to get to market before any other cattle from the basin. You'll have to move fast, Braden.
Oh, I am beginning to see. If you sell them 50,000 head, the buyers will have enough. They will offer little or nothing for the other cattle from the basin.
I'm hoping it'll be nothing. It'll be a bad year for the small ranchers. They won't have enough money to run until next year. They'll have to borrow. And if they can't borrow, they'll have to sell out at my price.
It's so simple. You will lose some money yourself, of course. 50,000 head at one time. You cannot hope for a top price.
I can afford to lose this money to get the land I want.
See, I congratulate you.
Don't bother to do that yet. You've got to move fast if it's going to work. You get down to San Antonio and hire those men pronto.
Breed, Tonto. Steele wouldn't have bothered to get him out of jail if we didn't have some work for him.
Not right.
It's strange that he should be leaving the basin just when the roundup is getting underway.
What you think, Kimasabe?
I don't know. I don't like the looks of it, though. You better follow him, Tonto.
Maybe him go a long way?
Well, it doesn't matter. Follow him wherever he goes. Follow him until you find out what he's up to.
Tonto do that.
And then, when you learn anything,
Tonto come back plenty fast.
Good luck, Kimasabe.
Get him up, scout.
One night, a week later, the Lone Ranger reined up in front of Jim Carey's ranch house. A great yellow moon was rising above the western hills that rimmed the basin. The distant lowing of the cattle and an occasional whinny from the mustangs in the corral were all that disturbed the silence of the night. The range country seemed at peace. But as he climbed the steps of the ranch house, the Lone Ranger's face was grim beneath his mask.
Steady, big fella. Good evening, Carey.
Well, I'll be dogged. The Lone Ranger. Come on in.
Thank you.
Too bad Abby and Ted aren't here. They've gone to a shindig at the bar end.
I was afraid you might be there, too.
Nope, I had a lot of figures to go over. Roundup time, I hardly ever leave the home range.
Then you don't know what's going on over at the Tomahawk.
Going on? You mean Steele's up to some funny business again?
Just answer me this. How do you split up your herd during the roundup?
Why, three ways, of course. The cows and the calves that are going to be branded, ones are going to drive to market, and the others.
The Tomahawk crew are only splitting their herd in two. Just cutting out the cows and calves. And they aren't doing any branding at all.
Only earmarking them, huh?
Not even that.
They'll have to.
Well, they aren't doing it now. It looks to me as if they're getting a trail herd together as fast as they can.
Well, what's the sense of it?
Gary, it'll be a trail herd such as the West has never seen. You know how many heads Peel has. Half of them would run the total to nearly 50,000.
But they can't drive that many to market.
No, not altogether.
There's no trail crew can handle more than 5,000.
They can split it up 10 ways.
But that would mean 10 crews. Now, Steele doesn't have that many men.
He doesn't now, but he may be able to hire them.
Well, not around here.
Speed rode south last week.
He did?
And he rode a long way. Gonzalo followed him, and he hasn't come back. There are plenty of men in San Antonio.
Yeah, but I can't figure it out, though. Why would Steele want to sell 50,000 here? He's got plenty of grass and water. And I doubt if the buyers in Clarksville would...
Would what?
50,000. $15 a head we're getting now.
You're beginning to realize.
That's $750,000. Why, a drive like that would break the market wide open.
How many were you planning to sell this year?
1,000 head.
And all the others in the basin.
Outside of Steele, you mean?
Yes.
Well, altogether, we'll have about 6,000 head.
Then you've got to beat Steele to Clarksville, or you won't get anything for them.
Well, we hadn't planned on starting yet.
Well, you've got to. Now, most of the small ranchers are over at the barn tonight, aren't they?
Yeah, I guess so.
Then go there.
It'd be hard to convince them Steele's up to a trick like that. You aren't sure.
That doesn't matter. They'll have to admit there's a chance of my being right.
Yeah.
And if there is, it means you have to act.
I'll talk to them. I'll give it to them straight. We'll get a part of the herd started tomorrow morning.
The sooner the better.
Someone just rode up.
Yes. Hello. You have news of Breed.
Kimatami. Me follow your trail from camp.
You had a long ride, Toto.
Scout plenty tired.
What did you find out?
Breed go to San Antonio. Him hire many men. Maybe 100.
You hear that, Terry?
Them get here by morning. All men wear 2 guns. Many killer.
That's the sort of men Breed would hire. Did you hear what he told them?
Toto here. Breed promised them get much money.
But are they going to stay at the Tomahawk Ranch?
No. Them drive big herd to Clarksville.
100 men, Kerry. Steele has nearly that many working for him already. Do you need any more proof?
I sure don't.
Can you get all your cattle on the trail tomorrow?
We can try. I'll make it to the bar M in 30 minutes. And when I get there, the party will be over. Now listen to me. I haven't finished. You can't be too careful about this. Can't weed out your cattle the way you usually do. We got to move fast.
All right.
Now, just make up your mind how many heads you want to send. Cut them out tonight and drive them to the flats along Banjo Creek. That's where we start from tomorrow morning.
All right.
Now, don't waste any time and talk. Get into your saddles and head for your home range, Toto. All
right. Where are you?
They're on to your game.
What do you mean?
Just what I said. I heard a lot of excitement at the Bar M Ranch.
Yeah, of course it is.
They was having a party, but they aren't anymore. I could hear Jim Cherry talking to him. I saw him start riding away.
What'd he say?
Almost word for word what you told the boys yourself.
They need to prove he's been blabbing it on to the range.
No, they haven't. It was a Lone Ranger figured it out and passed the word along to Cherry. Besides that, the Indian, what's his name, Tonto, he followed Breed to San Antonio. Your new man will be here tomorrow morning.
That's fine.
It'll be too late. You might as well send him back. Cherry's herd will be on its way.
They can start. I'd like to bet they never get to Clarksville.
Huh?
Now listen to me. Listen close and get everything straight. Afterwards, you're going to climb aboard that major Cayuse color horse and hightail it to the Roundup camp.
By sunrise the next morning, the small ranch's herd was taking shape in a flat near Banjo Creek. Hard-riding cowboys hazed the wild longhorns into one great milling mass. Hours passed as they rounded up the strays. At last, the herd was quieted down. Cherry was about to give the word to the drive to begin when the Lone Ranger and Tonto raced up.
Hey, there, boys.
Hello.
Well, set to go.
You'll have to wait.
What's that?
Steele has 3,000 head moving already. They'll reach the pass before you can.
Doggone, we'll have to wait until they get through.
You can't start your drive until this afternoon.
This is going to be bad. One herd in front of us, and Steele's sure to start another moving as soon as he can. It's like being between two fires.
Yes, Cherry. It's 400 miles to Clarksville. It'll be trouble every foot of the way.
The curtain falls on the first act of our Lone Ranger story. Before the next exciting scenes, please permit us to pause for just a few moments.
Thank you.
to continue our story. When Breed reined up in front of the Tomahawk Ranch House for the men he had hired in San Antonio, he slipped from the saddle and ran up the steps.
Daniel.
Take it home, Breed.
Yeah, I'm too late.
You'll be too.
You too. Carry any other smaller ranches. They have the trail herd ready to start. We're
seeing
at Bunch of Creek.
Sure, Breed, but we got 3,000 head going through the pass right now.
3,000? Supposed to be 50,000.
Well, don't get excited. You've had to change your plan. The Lone Ranger got wise.
Oh, the Lone Ranger.
He's smart. You gotta give him credit for that. But I hold all the trumps in this game, and I know how to play them.
You will explain, please. I do not understand.
It won't take me long. And you and the boys out there can go to work.
Carey's herd was driven through the pass late that afternoon. The Lone Ranger had been scouting the trail ahead. Carey found him waiting on the far side.
Oh, boy. Oh, there. Well, a two.
Yes, Carey.
Yes, if you like. Cover a couple of more miles before we have to bed the herd down.
You can't go any further tonight.
Why not?
Because Steele's herd is less than 2 miles ahead of you. The crew's made camp.
Huh? You mean to say they started before daybreak and didn't get any farther than that?
Didn't want to get any farther.
Didn't want to?
Now they're trying to hold you up. You can't go on because if your herd ever got mixed up with theirs, well, it would take a day to separate them.
Well, I know, but what good will it do to hold us up? They'll be just holding themselves up, too.
There's more to it than that. I've sent Tonto back to the pass. I'm afraid he'll be bringing us some bad news before long.
Well, here he comes now. What kind of news?
It's simple, Carey. Steele's going to start another herd as soon as he can.
Well, what of it? He can't move any faster than we do. He'll have to keep back a couple miles.
No, he doesn't.
What?
He might even stampede this next herd right into yours.
Leaping cactus.
Oh, what did you find out,
Tonto? You catch your think? More cattle on the way to pass now. And move plenty fast.
They're coming through the pass tonight.
We've got to go on, then. We've got to keep ahead of them.
You can't go on.
We've got to do something.
Yeah, there's one way out.
Name it.
Drive your cattle to the east for 20 miles and follow the Merrick to Clarksville.
That's twice as long. If we do that, we lose.
You want your herd to be stampeded? You want to lose most of them?
No, but
the Merrick's your only trail and only chance. If you drive 20 miles a day, you can get to Clarksville first.
20 miles a day?
If you stay here and try to drive through or around that herd up ahead, you'll never get there.
Doggone, I guess you're right.
Hey! Swing that point to the right. We're heading east for the Merrick trail.
Three nights later, Steele and Breed were camped with one of their trail crews on Spanish Creek. The rancher was in a bad temper.
Well, how did Jacob back yet?
I don't know, senor. He has gone since last night.
He got the whistle.
If he don't know, that would be the most good. I tell him to locate the Carey herd and report back at once.
Yeah. Pour me another cup of
coffee. See. Too bad they slip out of our trap.
What did they gain by it?
Nothing. The Merrick trail is too long. We get to Clarksville first, and that is all you want. It's just the same.
Just the same what?
It's hard to forget the Lone Ranger rides with him. He's not a man to be trusted.
Give me that coffee.
Si, senor.
Hello!
Jake.
It's about time.
Oh, Rusty.
Well, where have you been?
Just wait till I get my breath, I'll tell you.
Why have you taken so long to ride a few miles?
A few miles, nothing. I had to ride all the way to the Sweetwater before I caught up with him.
Sweetwater?
Why, it's not possible. They could not have got that fast. They would have to drive 20 miles a day. That's just what they're doing. I never saw a trail herd move so fast. I followed him along the ridge for a while. That masked man was everywhere. You should have seen him.
Reed.
Eh?
20 miles a day and they win.
That is so.
You get to stop them. Tomorrow night, you'll take 20 of the best men you got in San Antonio.
He's clogged up. There may be storm tomorrow night.
Without a help. Just make sure that herd is scattered so they'll never be able to round it up again.
See?
That isn't all. From now on, we drive 20 miles a day ourselves. A pass the weight along.
Night, the Carey herd was bedded down north of Sweetwater. Just before dawn, the Lone Ranger rode up to the dying campfire. Carey was rolled up in his blanket beside it, sound asleep.
Steady, big fella.
Carey.
Hello there. It's 5 o'clock yet, is it?
No, I've just been taking a look at the herd.
Don't you ever sleep?
I can't be much more sleep for any of us tonight.
Something wrong? Storm.
Yes, it'll break any minute. Cattle are getting restless.
I can hear them.
You're night riders.
What are they shouting for? There's no way to quiet cattle.
Gunfire. You may have sent some men after us. Here, Silver.
Roll out of your blanket, boys. They've got a storm and a possible of coyotes to deal with.
Whoa, Silver.
Before the Lone Ranger reached the herd, the gunfire had stopped. In the flash of lightning, he saw a band of horsemen disappearing over the ridge. There was no time to follow them. The cattle were already milling, and at that moment, the storm broke in all its fury. Almost at once, the longhorn started to run before the driving rain. Jagged streaks of lightning cracked over the earth.
Great balls of fire played above the heads of the terror-stricken cattle. On they race. A stampede.
You give the orders, Mad Man.
All we can do is run with them. The point left up. We try to turn the leaders.
Keno!
One, two, three.
Cattle ran for 10 miles before the last of the thunder rumbled away in the distance. And the Lone Ranger directed the cowboys in the desperate work of getting the herd under control once more. Hour after hour of hard riding followed. Sky clear. The sun rose high in the heavens. It was nearly noon, and the last of the strays were rounded up, and the herd was started back.
10 miles back to where we left the chuck wagon. You won't get there until dark. Full day, Lord.
Yes,
Terry? I'd like to lay my hands on the skunks that started the stampede.
They're back to their own herds by now.
They just can't win, Mac, man.
Terry? They'd like you to give up.
They know where we are. They know how far we've gone. That means they'll get along a lot faster themselves.
Otto?
Uh-huh.
You and I are riding on to Clarksville.
You're leaving us?
Yes, Terry. We'll be back. No. Meantime, keep driving as hard as you can. Come on, Silver. Help!
Ready, big fella?
Oh,
what's that? Clarksville, last little copy. Well, we have 3 hours before dawn. Are you sure this is John Bennett's house?
That's right.
Well, the door won't be locked. We'll walk right in. There's a lamp on the table.
What's that? Mass failing engine.
You're covered, Bennett. I've had a call for help.
Hey, what's the idea?
Get into your clothes. You're leaving town with us.
It was over 2 weeks later that Steele and Breed rode into Clarksville at the head of their first herd. There was no sign of Kerry, and the rancher congratulated himself as he walked along the main street toward John Bennett's office.
Yeah, we put it off, Breed. Cattle before you get a town all this week. When Kerry shows up, he won't get a dime for his tears. Here, this is the place.
I know Benny would be surprised when you tell him how many heads on the way here.
Steele.
Hello. Where's your boss?
You mean Mr. Bennett?
Yeah, where is he?
I don't know. Nobody knows. He just disappeared about 2 weeks ago.
Disappeared?
Yeah. He left the office one night and went home, and the next day he wasn't anywhere to be found. Sheriff's had a posse looking for him.
You must have found some trace.
No, we didn't. He didn't say anything to anybody about leaving town, and we haven't had any word. Well, we don't know what happened to him.
Well, I got 3,000 cattle down in the corrals. They want to sell them.
Well, there's other buyers in town. I can't.
Yeah, I think enough to handle this deal. The 3,000 are only a starter.
Yeah, it's better we go to the sheriff, maybe.
This deal goes wrong at the last minute just because Bennett takes it into his head.
Wait a minute. Yeah, somebody stop us. Hey, it's Mr. Bennett.
What kind of a yarn are you trying to make me swallow?
I told the truth, but look who's with him. A masked man and an engine. You better get the sheriff.
He's the Lone Ranger.
Hello, everybody.
What's the meaning of this village?
Where have you been? You don't mind, masked man. I'd like you and Chandler to stick around a little while in case there's any trouble.
Well, he'd be glad to. There won't be any trouble.
Now, Steele, what can I do for you?
Where have you been?
Oh, we're just taking a little business trip. Been seeing an old friend of mine.
That's a likely story. What do you say? You've been gone 2 weeks.
Yeah, that's right. Any objections?
I want to talk to you alone.
No, thanks. If you've got anything to say, you better get it off your chest right now.
All right. Want to sell some cattle?
About 50,000 head, isn't it?
The masked man told you.
He's told me a lot of things.
Well, what do you give me for them?
Market price, $15 a head.
Have you gone local?
Well, $15 a head. I'll only buy 10,000.
Now, wait. You'd take the whole 50 if I offered them to you at, let's say, 5.
10,000's all I can handle. We've already bought 6.
You've what?
Yeah, from Jim Carey. Rode out with a masked man and met him on the trail.
Can you see?
That's it.
I'll break it for this minute.
Yeah, and how do you plan to do that?
Yeah, I'll tell you how. I'll sell all my cattle to the other buyers around here. $5. 2-1, I don't care. You'll never be able to get rid of that 6,000.
No sale, Steele. I'm talking for all the buyers in town. We'll take 10,000 from you and not one more.
That's a double cross.
Yes, a double cross, Brady.
Yeah.
You'll go, Bennett. I'm offering you a chance to make a fortune. You're turning it down.
John Bennett doesn't figure the same way you do, Steele. I've told him that you're trying to ruin every small rancher in Tomahawk Basin. If that happens, he knows he'll have to deal with you alone.
Then I'll be the one to get ruined. No thanks, Steele. All us ranchers, and we're going to stick together and play along with the small guy. The market price for beef stays where it is.
What if we only sell 10,000 heads? What we do with other 40,000?
You can rent some range land and winter them around here.
When I sold them in the spring, I wouldn't make a cent.
Right, Steele. That has cost you a lot of money. Let's go, Tonto.
So long, Mass Man. I enjoyed the trip.
You'll never regret your decision, Bennett. As for you, Steele, you'll see that Jim Carey's herd gets here safely. And Tonto and I are riding back to the basin. We'll meet again.
Yes, we'll meet again. And the next time, Breed, I promise you, the tables will be turned.
Thank you.
just heard is a copyright feature of the Lone Ranger Incorporated.